rich kids.
Have you guys ever saved up for something to buy that cost a lot of money?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
How much did it cost?
$50.
Did you feel like it was worth the money you spent on it?
Yes.
Very worth it. It's a great game.
What made it worth it?
Comedy filled and action packed.
So, Maddie, what are we going to learn about today?
What we're going to learn about today is the cost of following Jesus. But first, let's sing some songs to God.
It's time to pray. We're talking today about how it can be hard to follow Jesus because he can ask us to do hard things and to trust him. So let's pray and ask God for help. God loves to help us. I'll go first and then you pray, okay? God, we are so thankful that you help us all the time. You tell us that you give us your spirit to help us. That's our scripture memory verse. Thanks, God, for telling us what's true. And we need your help. Please help us to trust you, to do whatever you ask us to do, to obey you and to think about others and to share our toys Thank you, God, for helping us and giving us your spirit so that we can do these hard things. It's your turn. God, we thank you that you hear our prayers. Thank you for Jesus, for dying for our sin. And we pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Good job. Has anyone ever told you that you look like your mom or your dad? You look like them because you're from them. You're their child. And you know, when we are God's children, we start to look like Jesus. And we start to do what Jesus did. And that's why we want to read the Bible, so we can know what Jesus did, so that we can be more like him. And when your parents are going somewhere, and they're saying, come on, let's get in the car, we're going to go do this or that, you trust them, right? You go with them. You follow where they go, because you know they're going to do good things and take you to places that you need to be. Well, it's like that with Jesus. He wants us to follow him and trust him with our life, whatever we're doing that day or that year, for our whole lives. Just like we trust our parents, we can trust God our Father, because Jesus shows us that God is good and he is worthy to do whatever he asks of us. That's what our story is about today.
Hey friends, it's me, Megan, and I'm Jessie. Jessie, how was your class at church this morning?
Oh, it was so fun, Megan. We learned from the Bible and we played Follow the Leader.
Oh, that is a fun game. Did you get a turn at being the leader?
Oh yeah, I marched and clapped and laid my arms and patted my tummy, and everyone had to do what I was doing because I was the leader.
Wow, did you do all that at one time? That sounds really hard.
Oh no, I did one thing at a time.
Okay, good. In today's Bible story, Jesus talked about what it is like to follow him.
Oh, cool. So when we follow Jesus, we do what he does?
Yep. And it's not always easy, but it is always worth it. Listen to the story.
Many people wanted to follow Jesus. Large crowds followed him around. One man said, "Teacher, I will follow you wherever you go." Jesus told the man, "Foxes have dens, and birds of the sky have nests, but the Son of Man has no place to lie down." Another disciple said, "Lord, I will follow you, but first let me go and bury my father." Jesus replied, "Follow me, and let the dead bury their own dead." Jesus told the crowds that following him would not be easy. "Anyone who comes to me must be willing to leave everything," he said. "You must love me most of all, more than your own life. Anyone who thinks life should be easy cannot follow me," Jesus said. Jesus wanted the people to choose carefully. He told them a story. If you wanted to build a tower, you would first sit down and see what you would need to make the tower. If you did not, you would build the foundation and could not finish. People would laugh at you. Then he told them another story. If you were a king, you would not go to war against another king without thinking about if your army is great enough to win the war. If you don't have enough men to fight, you would send some men to ask for peace before the fighting even started. Jesus wanted people to think about the cost. If you are not willing to give up everything you have, you cannot follow me, Jesus said. Whoever gives up his life for me will find true life. What good is it to have everything you want in the world if you give up life with God forever. Following Jesus is not easy, but He is worth it. When we trust in Jesus, we give Him complete control of our lives. Jesus gave up His own life to rescue people from sin and give us life with God forever.
Some people followed Jesus because they thought He was going to make their life easier and give them everything they wanted. But Jesus is teaching us in this story that sometimes following Jesus is hard, and it costs us something. And it cost Jesus life. Remember how He died on the cross? It cost Him pain because He wanted us to know God and be with God. So He took away our sin, but that was hard. And so when we follow Jesus, He's going to ask us to do hard things too, like share and think of others before we think of ourselves, and to obey our parents. He asks us these things, and it means we have to trust Him. And He's worthy of our trust. And anything that we can give, it's worth it to follow Jesus. So let's answer some questions about this story, and we'll see you here next time. Bye.